Postman Pat, Speedy Car, by John A. Cunliffe, narrated by Michele Melega. Speedy Car. One morning, Postman Pat was on his way to work when he saw Julian in fancy dress.
"Hey there, cowboy," said Pat. "Nice lasso."
"It's Bill's birthday," said Julian. "We've planned a special party with a surprise present."
Just then, Postman Pat's phone rang. It was Ben.
"I have a special delivery for you, Pat," he said.
"It might be Bill's gift," cried Julian. "Can I come?"
"Okay," laughed Pat as they jumped into the van.
At the sorting office, Ben said that there were three parcels for Postman Pat to deliver.
"Two are for Bill, and one is for Ted Glenn. Bill needs his parcels by 1 p.m., and Ted needs his right away."
"No problem," said Postman Pat.
"Thanks, Pat," said Ben. "Enjoy the party."
"Yeah,"
cried Julian as they climbed into the van. At Ted's garage, Pat and Julian heard a bang.
"Wait here, Julian," said Pat as he ran inside.
"I'll get the parcel,"
said Julian, and he picked up the one he thought was for Ted. Inside, Ted was fixing Mrs. Goggin's TV.
"All I need now is the remote control," he said.
"Here it is,"
said Julian, handing Ted the parcel.
"Come on," said Postman Pat. "We mustn't be late to deliver Bill's birthday present."
After Pat and Julian had gone, Ted opened his parcel.
"Now that's what I call a remote control," he said.
Ted flicked the switch, but nothing happened. He tried again, but the remote didn't work.
"Oh, that's strange," said Ted.
Meanwhile, in the back of Postman Pat's van, there was a strange noise.
"That's odd," said Pat, and he pulled over to take a look.
As Pat and Julian opened the van door, a racing car burst out of the parcel.
"It's Bill's present," cried Julian. "It's getting away."
"Not if I can help it," said Pat, as they jumped into the van.
Pat and Julian chased the runaway car, but it kept whizzing off in different directions.
"What are we going to do?" asked Julian.
"It's a remote-controlled car," said Pat. "The remote will be in the other parcel. We'll use that."
Pat opened the parcel that was in the van.
"Oh, no,"
he cried. "This is the TV remote. Ted has the remote for the car."
"Bill will never get his present now," sighed Julian.
"Don't worry, Julian," said Pat. "We'll get that birthday present to Bill on time, I promise."
At Ted's garage, Mrs. Goggins had come to collect her TV. Suddenly, the racing car whizzed past and Bonnie jumped on it.
"No, Bonnie!" cried Mrs. Goggins. "Stop!"
Postman Pat and Julian arrived as the car sped off with Bonnie.
"You've got the remote for the car, Ted," cried Pat. "You need to stop it."
Ted tried the switch, but nothing happened.
"It's because I changed the wiring," he said.
Pat and Julian quickly jumped into the van.
"Stop that car,"
cried Postman Pat to PC Selby.
Suddenly, the car zoomed into a field.
"It's heading for the cliff," said Postman Pat. "What about Bonnie?" cried Mrs. Goggins.
Pat threw a stick, and Bonnie jumped to catch it. The car zoomed off and got stuck in a bush on the cliff edge.
"The car is going to fall," said Pat.
Suddenly, he had an idea.
"Julian, have you still got your lasso?" asked Pat.
"Yes,"
replied Julian as he handed it over. Postman Pat threw the lasso and hooked it over the car. Pat tugged and pulled the car to safety.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.